I've been absolutely loving this real-time API from OpenAI, and recently they released this WebRTC interface, or Web Real-Time Communication. And I've been playing with it, and one of my favorite things to do that I found from exploring it is that you can do tool calling, but on the client side, like from good old browser-based JavaScript. You aren't gonna believe what you can make this thing do. So if you aren't familiar with tool calling yet, it's a way for you to tell your AI application that it has some additional capabilities. And what happens is if it thinks that it should use them, it returns you a function name with some arguments. Now, typically what happens is that you get that call, that function, and you return the result back to your LLM. Now, this is one way that people are doing all these agents that people are talking about. They give these functions access to external APIs and they allow it to perform tasks. But what's different here is that instead of running those functions on a server somewhere, I can actually run them in the browser, like in real time. And it unlocks some pretty bonkers use cases. Here, let me show you. So I have a worker that is connecting to the OpenAI WebRTC URL here. And I'm passing in my protected credentials. And then what I'm doing is I'm passing that down to the browser. So now what I can do is I can just talk to AI like this. Refresh this page. Hey there, I'm recording a video about how you can do tool calling.
That sounds like a great project. What kind of tool calls are you planning to demonstrate in your video? If you need help or more information on-
Let's do this. Can you make the background color orange? Awesome, and can you make the text blue? Cool. Actually, let's make the background the color of a beautiful sunset. Ooh, and now let's make that text the color that would feel better, the text right in there. Make it feel better. It feels kind of gross currently. A little bit better. It's kind of hard to read. Can you fix that?
Let's improve the readability. How about we change the text color to a high contrast color, like white?
Great.
Let's go ahead and update that.
Super fun, right? So I also, what I did was I console logged over here. I console logged what was happening. You can see that I said I want to change the background color and then he changed it to that color, right? So, and it returns the arguments in hex because it translated that, right? Because it was what it needed when I described that. Now it can also get information, like I can say, what does the button say on that web page? So it got back the HTML.
Yes, by getting the HTML of the page, I can extract information about the elements on the page. From the HTML provided, there's a button with the text, talk to the hand. This is what the button says on that web page. If there's anything else you'd like to know.
And you'll see that I can interrupt as it's going. So that's really powerful too, right? So what I want to show now, I don't know if you know this or not, but I've been playing with Bluetooth devices recently, and you can actually connect to those devices through your browser. So I'm going to click this talk to the hand button, and now I'm going to pair with this hand because I have this robot hand that I've been playing with. So now I've connected over Bluetooth. The hand is ready. So here we go. Check this out. Hold up one finger, please. Pretty rad. How about two? Great. Now, ready? Let's play a game. So I'm going to ask you questions and you control the robot hand to answer my question. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Ask your questions and I'll use the robot hand to respond. Let's play.
In which Superman movie starred Richard Pryor?
If you could provide the full question about Richard Pryor in a Superman movie, I'll be ready to answer using the robot hand.
All right.
What would you like to ask?
Which Superman movie had Richard Pryor in it?
The Superman movie featuring Richard Pryor is Superman 3.
Killer.
To indicate this with a robot hand.
Great. You did a great job. How many Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles are there? That's right. And how many Chipettes are there in Alvin and the Chipmunks? Awesome. Which Terminator movie did that dude start turning into liquid?
The Terminator movie where the T-1000 starts turning into liquid is Terminator 2, Judgment Day.
That's right. How about you lift up all those hands, all those fingers, all them. All right, so let's take a look at the code really quick. In here, right, I just have this standard script.js, just standard JavaScript. Here's where I'm declaring the functions, right? So I'm gonna get back the outer HTML, got this background color. These are just the functions that I'm doing. And I'm just changing the background color. And I declare them when I pass it in, I create this, the RTC peer connection. I create one of those. It has a data channel. So this is how it's talking, right? This is how we set things up with RTC. I create a data channel called response. And I define the functions very specifically, right? Changes the background color of a web page to a hex value of that color, right? And the robot finger controls a robot hand to show a specific number of fingers. And the name of that, right, is show fingers. And I say values 1 through 5, right? Because it doesn't have more than that. So I'm going to come up here and you see when it says show fingers, hand send command, number of fingers. So let's take a look at that. So the code, when it comes back, we'll get this function call arguments done. We'll get that across the message that comes back, right? So we'll parse that out. I'll make sure that this is the done, and then I'll get the message name, and I'm only gonna run the function that's available there, right? So only if I've defined that function. So I get the function, I call it, and I return the results because I want it to know that it worked, right? If it didn't work, it should also know that. So you get to see the function calls there. Pretty cool, right? The repo is attached to the notes of this video. I hope that triggered some ideas for you on client-side tools that you could use. As you saw, it's just a JavaScript function, so you can quite literally do anything, including even making a call to a REST API. The sky's the limit. Let me know what you build with this client-side tool calling. It is such a bonkers time to be a builder, and even more so now that you could do it with any web page. WebRTC is such a powerful technology, and I'm going to continue to explore what's possible. We have a Cloudflare product that actually uses WebRTC named calls, and it uses WebRTC to make real-time video calls. And I think I might try to invite my AI friend to do some tricks. If you liked hanging out, make sure to subscribe to the Cloudflare Developers YouTube channel. We have tons of fun projects like this. Ooh, speaking of which, can you make the robot hand hold up the peace sign? Peace. Thanks for hanging out, and we'll see you real soon. Thanks, man. You did such a great job.
Thank you, Manny. It was a pleasure working with you. Looking forward to more fun projects in the future.
Let's do this.